We build a versatile pack. On the left-hand side is a modern-day flat plate design pack that Phil was talking about. We had, early on, we had the ability to talk to several people in the electric utility industry about what they liked on their separators, what they didn't like. They gave us the feedback, and almost invariably, you know, they said, look, it's the coalescer. They foul quickly. They don't process solids, and we can't keep in compliance over this. So when we designed our system a little more than 20 years ago, we found that this is what we keyed on. We keyed on long runs between maintenance. And we found that if we dealt with solids and also kept the criteria for, down in that 60 micron range, we're going to be in good shape for long periods of time for our clients. So the first thing you're going to note is that this coalescer shown here, this is an entry area view. We're a little higher so you can see some depth. Basically, this is an entry area view. So the flow is coming in this area right here. You'll notice flat plate design. It's a flat plate that goes all the way through the coalescer pack. Critical. And we're finding that this time-honored flat plate design is something we've come full circle on. This was the original design concept. And the flat plate design at a 55-degree steep angle, that's where we are here. If you're in a 55 or 60-degree angle, you have a much better shot of solids falling down and out of the plate pack system. But the fact is that if we're steep and we have a flat plate design, there are no nooks and crannies. If you look at the other designs we looked at today, lots of nooks and crannies, lots of places for the solids to lodge in. And once solids lodge in a plate, they kind of grow off of each other and the fouling goes much more quickly. A cross-flow design. In today's marketplace, all the real designers go with a cross-flow design. Phil mentioned the upflows and the downflows. They're both countercurrent. Meaning one of the components, like solids, has to fight against the flow of water. When it does that, it tends to ramp up and plug. So if you move this to a countercurrent design like we have here, water's flowing here, and water flows through the separator all the way to the back end. Water, oil, and solids all are heading in the same general direction. With that, you can keep the plate gaps here much tighter without the same fouling.